has in store for me. No ear has heard what God has in store for me, say.
este día.
Good morning and welcome to the Christian House of Prayer Ministries, where we are one house. We pray that you will experience the light, life, and love of God during today's service. We invite you to join us at any and all of our services. Now, let's get ready to worship.
Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Glory to God! I would like to say good morning to the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. All power to the Creator, Sustainer of all things. You're worthy to be praised. Good morning, Chop family. Good morning, friends, visitors, and social media. We say good morning to all. May everyone who can stand, please stand. Thank you. Okay. For the Lord is our strength this morning. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. So we enter your gates with thanksgiving this morning with and your praise to be to the Lord. Yes, Lord. We say that. Okay. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. Father, we enter your gates with thanksgiving and your courts with praise this morning. For the joy of the Lord is our strength. We come into your presence, Father God, with open hearts and grateful and thankfulness, Father. Father, we say we lean not into our own understanding, but in all our ways we will acknowledge you. Say, Father, as the saints assemble themselves in their seats, I will say, let our hearts be quietened, and may we have no agenda but to make you happy and glorify your holy name. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Father, I would like to share something with the people that our bishops preached on Wednesday night. He said that that faith was the mediator of our Lord Jesus, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Yes. He said that the Wednesday night service was Matthew 9 and 27, and the message was okay, Lord. Faith, the mediator of exchange. And that is verses. I am. He is the great I am. And he says that supernatural versus these suspicious faith. So, Father God, we are going to Hebrews 11 and 11 and say, faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. And chapter 6 goes to say, without faith, we can do nothing. Yes, Lord. Father God, and since Bishop was teaching on faith, it is written in your word, chapter 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verses 4 and 8. Which teaches us that love is patient, love is kind, it does not envy, it does not boast, it is not proud, it keeps no records of wrong. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices in the truth. Love always hopes, always protects, always perseveres. Love never fails. And our growth in the agape love of Christ Jesus takes us to Galatians 5 and 22. The true faith is the fruits of the Spirit. Yes. Love, yes. Joy, yes. Peace, long-suffering, yes. gentleness, goodness, faithfulness, meekness, and temperance. Against these things there is no law. So, Father, have your way in this sanctuary. Let every train be filled in this temple as we praise you with our whole hearts, our mind, our body, and our soul. Father, teach us how you move, how you work, so we can go onward in your name until everything within us brings you honor to your name. Our only desire this morning is to make you happy. Now, Father, we want to thank you for our lead sheep, Pastor Valerie Hogan. Her sacrifice and the sacrifice of her children and family touches not only the hearts of and minds of CHOP, but has reached many around the globe. With her prayers and support. And Father, we thank you for her. We thank you for her beauty, her grace, and her anointing, which she shares unconditionally in service to our life-changing King. To God be the glory. Now, Father, we come thanking you for our elders, our staff, our deacons, every auxiliary, and each and every member. We thank you for all who are in ministry, in service to our Lord. And Father, we thank you for those who come forward for salvation,
thank you, Lord,
rededications, and church membership. May those becoming a part of this ministry never regret it. May those that they will be steadfast, unmovable, always in the works of the Lord. Lord, for it is all about him.
It's all about him.
And we give you all praise, honor, and glory. This is one house in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Let the people of the Lord say hallelujah. Glory to your name. God, we bless you. We honor you. We give you the glory. Hallelujah. Come on and just clap your hands right there. We serve a great and mighty God. Great and mighty is he. Great and mighty is he. Clothed in glory, arrayed in splendor. Great and mighty is he. Lift your voice and say,
Clothed in glory, arrayed in splendor.
honor you, Jesus. We glorify you, God. We thank you. I call you holy. I call you mighty. I call you righteous. Hallelujah. Oh, I call you holy. Your name is holy. You are so holy to me.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. How do y'all know, how many of y'all know that the Lord is faithful? How many of you know that the Lord will keep you in the midst of your storm? Let us declare what the Lord has already decreed in Psalms 91. He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress. My God, in Him will I trust. Surely He shall deliver thee from the snare of the fowler and from the noisome pestilence. He shall cover thee with His feathers, and under His wings shall thou trust. His truth shall be thy shield and buckler. Thou shalt not be afraid for the terror by night, nor for the arrow that flieth by day, nor for the pestilence that walketh in darkness, nor for the destruction that wasteth at noonday. 1,000 shall fall at thy side, and 10,000 at thy right hand. But it shall not come nigh thee. Only with thine eyes shall I behold and see the reward of the wicked. Because thou hast made the Lord, which is my refuge, even the Most High, thy habitation. There shall no evil befall thee, neither shall any plague come nigh thy dwelling. There he shall keep his angels charge over thee, to keep thee in all thy ways. There shall bear thee up in their hands, lest thou dash thy foot against the stone. Thou shalt tread upon the lion and the adder, the young lion and the dragon shall thou trample under feet. Because how he has set his love upon me, therefore will I deliver him. I will set him on high, because he has known my name. He shall call upon me, and I will answer him. I will be with him in trouble. I will deliver him and honor him. With long life will I satisfy him and show him my salvation. Hallelujah, hallelujah. You may be seated. Amen. At this time, we would like to recognize those of you who have come here for the very first time on behalf of our very own Pastor Valerie. So if this is your very first time here at the Christian House of Prayer this morning, would you please stand? Amen, amen. I see you. I see you. Amen, amen, amen. Amen. Hallelujah. At this time, you should have been given a welcome packet by our ushers so graciously. And within that welcome packet is a name card. If you would take that out and write your name on it and affix it to the upper part of your garment so that the people here at the Christian House of Prayer will be able to call you by name and share the love of the Lord with you after service. But also, there's another card in there with a QR code. On your free time, when you can, scan that, and you'll get a very own personal message from our pastor. Amen. Amen. But we also want to take the time out to recognize those of you who have just come back after a while. You may have been away for whatever the reason, but you're back here in the Christian House of Prayer for the first time after a long time this morning. Would you also stand at this time? Anyone, anyone? Amen. Welcome back to the home. Welcome back home. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. We'd also like to recognize those of you that are here watching, and the CCI people that are here worshiping with us via social media. We also want to encourage you to like, share, and subscribe today's service, and be able to hit that notification bell as well, so that anytime we have a service, you will be notified. Amen. Now, if you were to direct your attention to the Jumbotron for further announcements.
Celebrating 59 years of marriage today, March 17th, is Robert and Carolyn Duncan. The Christian House of Prayer family wishes this couple a happy anniversary and many more to come. The Christian House of Prayer's Youth and Young Adult Service is taking place now in the lecture hall. We invite all youth ages 13 to 19 and young adults ages 20 to 35 to come and join us now. The Christian House of Prayer's Total Solar Eclipse Watch Party is just around the corner. This special event will be held on April 8th in the Killeen and Coppers Cove parking lot locations. There will be food and drinks provided. This total solar eclipse event will not come around again until 2044. So if you're interested in being a part of this very rare event, register online at CHOP.org and the CHOP app. The Refuge Mobile Food Pantry will hold its March distribution on Saturday, March 23rd from 9 to 11 a.m. at the Richard E. Cavazos Elementary School at 1200 North 10th Street in Nolanville. If you or someone you know is in need of a helping hand, please stop by and receive this blessing on Saturday, March 23rd from 9 a.m. to 11 a.m. at 1200 North 10th Street in Nolanville. The Christian House of Prayer is encouraging all of our members this Resurrection Sunday to invite someone to church. Resurrection Sunday will be Sunday, March 31st, so let's get a head start and make plans now to invite someone to church on Sunday, March 31st, during our 10 a.m. service. The Christian House of Prayer's Hymn Books in the Foyer has reopened and is available to serve you. Take advantage of our ongoing sale on previous year's mantra note takers, available in binders and spirals. You may also purchase selected CDs on sale right now, so stop by and see us. We also have the new 2024 Mantra Spirals available for purchase. Stop by and visit us before or after service at Hymn Books in the Foyer. Coming in April to the Christian House of Prayer, it's a special class dealing with the manifestation and healing power of God and the subject of abortion. Join Sister Deborah Morrell on Saturday, April 6th at 10 a.m. in the lecture hall for The Secrets in Your Past, a testimony of post-abortive healing and redemption. This class is open to anyone who is struggling with secrets from their past and is longing to walk in God's freedom and peace from shame, torment, and condemnation. Join us on Saturday, April 6th at 10 a.m. for this special class, Secrets in Your Past, a testimony of post-abortive healing and redemption with Sister Deborah Morrell in the lecture hall.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. What time is it, Chop? I said, what time is it, Chop? Amen, amen. If you're in need of a tithes and offering envelope at this time, would you please raise your hands and our ushers will be more than happy to accommodate you. You know, as a young man growing up, I never quite understood tithing. And I've always seen my parents give and the people in the church give, and I never understood it. But I did it anyway. And I can confidently say that giving does something to your heart. It changes your heart's posture in such a way that you're able to be of help to those around you. So I encourage you this morning to, even if you don't want to, I encourage you to give this morning. To give, amen. Let us say our confession of faith. Amen. Father God, we thank you for this morning, Father God, for waking us up this morning, for starting us on our way, Father God. And I pray that even now, that as we prepare to position ourselves to give this morning, that you'll bless some 60, some 30, and some even 100-fold, Father God, this morning. And it's in Jesus' name we do pray. Amen and amen. Amen. Hallelujah. people are standing in line to get into this church to hear the word of God. Every seat is filled in every service with expectations of signs, wonders, and miracles. Our Sunday morning service at 10 o'clock in Killeen and any other service that we might have. Every need in this ministry is met, and we are 100% tithe givers. All of our property is paid off in full, and we owe nothing to no man but to love. Every member of this church is healed, healthy, blessed, and prosperous, and we are reaching the world with the gospel through our prayers and support. For this is a prosperous year for us, and the door of success has been opened. We shall succeed in everything in Christ. The doors of failure have been closed, and we shall not know defeat. For this is a prosperous year for us, and the door of success has been opened. We shall succeed in everything in Christ. The doors of failure have been closed, and we shall not know defeat. For this is a prosperous year for us, and the door of success has been opened. We shall succeed in everything in Christ. The doors of failure have been closed, and we shall not know defeat. And being fully persuaded that what he has promised, he was able also to perform, Iris encourages you, and his love comforts you. God's Spirit unites you, and you are concerned for others. Now make me completely happy. Live in harmony by showing love for each other. Be united in what you think, as if you were only one person. It's at God's urgency of now. We are one house. In Jesus' name, amen and amen.
your glory. Come on, somebody help us ask him to fill this house. Fill this house with your presence. Oh Lord, we need you to fill this house. Fill this house with your glory. We seeking you, oh Lord. Fill this house. Fill this house with your presence.
Yeah. abundance. We hear the sounds of glory. We see the angels saying, holy, holy, holy. The whole earth is filled with your glory. We are glorious unto you, Father. We are worshiping you. We love you with all of our hearts, all of our minds, all of our souls, and all of our beings, Lord. And we know, dear Lord, that you're doing something here, even now, Father. You're making the crooked things straight. You're making the crooked things straight. You're opening up doors that have never been opened before. You're giving us visions. You're letting us see, Lord, what the Washington Army is doing now in the spiritual realm, that we're pushing back the powers of darkness. We're pushing back the powers of darkness and possibility. Answer prayers. Answer prayers. Bodies are being healed now. Bodies are being healed now. Minds are being restored. The broken heart is being mended at this very moment. Know that the Lord, He is God. He is the maker of everything. Everything. Those that came in this morning with problems, concerns, weariedness, and don't know what's going on. The Holy Spirit said, I'm doing a new thing. I'm doing a thing that you have never seen before in your own personal lives. Some have waited and have waited and have waited and have waited. But my timing is just as important as my will. And this is the time of refreshing, saith the Spirit of the Lord. So get in to what you say you are into by opening up your heart to know that I have seen your struggles. I have heard your cries. And I have dispatched the answers to everybody's prayer. So lift up your hands and lift up your worship unto me, saith the Spirit of the Lord, because I have not forgotten you. It is coming. It is coming, and it has already come, saith the Spirit of the Lord. It has already come. And so we thank you, Father, and we give you glory, we give you honor, and we give you praise. Let God's people just say, thank you, Jesus, for being a very present help in a time of need. Hallelujah. You may have your seats in the presence of our life-changing King. Thank you, glorious praise dancers, under the leadership of Minister Lavelle. God bless you. God bless you. I tell you, the young people, they're catching the spirit and the vision. The Lord is doing it. He's doing it. He's doing it, people. He's doing it. And we got to rejoice, because even when we can't, I looked at him and I was jumping up and I said, God, those were the days. Those were the days, but what we could do is root them on. We could just root them on. Hallelujah, because they're taking their place. No, I don't see. I don't see. I don't see. No worries. All worries have been dispatched. I saw the worries go up like a whirlwind up out of this place. I see the Shekinah glory just resting upon us right now. Let's just reach up and take it. It belongs to us. It's ours. It's ours. Praise the Lord. Good morning, Christian House of Prayer family. And thank you all for coming out this morning on this cloudy, brisky day. But you are in the house of the Lord, and I'm so honored and blessed to be in the midst of you this morning. We have many of our congregation is over there. I didn't know that the 35-year-olds was going. I said, wait a minute now. I know you said the 13 through 19. You're taking the 20 through the 35. Wait a minute now. But they're over there. They're casting the vision. And the vision is change. Change is God has a new generation emerging. Christ has a now generation equipping. So the emerging is emerging as the equipping are equipping. Working together, singing together, dancing together, worshiping the Lord in spirit and in truth. And so the vision has to be cast because it's not really something that can be taught. It has to be caught. You have to catch it. And I'll tell you, we're catching it. We're catching it. We're catching it. We got it. Amen. I want to thank all of you for your prayers. In my absence, I truly had an awesome time. And you know, I had an awesome time. And you know, sometimes you have to have a vacation from the vacation. But that wasn't possible. That was just not possible. I was trying to see how I could fit that vacation from the vacation in, but it just wasn't profitable. But I'm glad to be back in the house of the Lord. No matter where I go, no matter what I do, it's nothing like home. Always yearn to be back home with the people of God and with the people that you love and the people that love you and the people that you know. And so I'm glad to be back in the house of the Lord this morning. And again, social media family, welcome this morning. And we are honored to have you in this house, the Christian House of Prayer. We call this the living room of God because we know that all things are possible in this house. God can do some things. The Lord can do some things that we never thought was possible to do when we come together in spirit and in truth. So we pray that you are there and you're ready to receive our new members. This is such an exciting time for us. And we want to say welcome, welcome, welcome. Let us know that you're there. Send out some messages. Let us know. Just say hi, praise the Lord, whatever. Just let us know that you're there because you certainly are a part of our family now. And we love you. And if you're ever in this area, please stop by and let us see who you are so we can hug on you and love on you and thank you for tuning in with us. Do we have anyone this morning that has come as a result of social media? Because we do have some that come sometimes and we don't ask. But do we have anybody that has come today as a result of social media? Amen. Well, praise the Lord. Well, Well, you're here, and we thank God for that. Then Covenant Connection International, we've already been welcomed, but I love you, and I miss you all so much, and thank you all for tuning in. A lot of them tune in before they go to church. Sometimes they tune in after they get out of church, but I thank the Lord for our family, our extended family, through Covenant Connection International. And all of our first-time visitors and our return friends, good morning to you. And we pray that you already feel the presence of a life-changing King. God bless you for coming. And then Deaconess Lena Roundtree, praise the Lord. God bless you, woman of God. God bless you, woman of God. Thank you for reminding us that faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. And without faith, it's impossible to please him, and you pleased him this morning with your faith. God bless you, woman of God. And then move it in sync with what we're doing, we're equipping. How about Minister Joshua Davis? Praise the Lord. Amen. We're blessed. We're blessed. We're blessed. We're blessed. We're blessed. And so this morning, we have the pleasure of inducting our newly members in the Christian House of Prayer. The count, they said, from January up until now is 50. We have 50 new members that have come to join the ministry from January to now. Amen. And these that will come up this morning are those that have completed the classes, and those other ones are still completing the classes, so keep them in prayer because the classes represent, or it's twofold for it.
information about the ministry so you'll know what you're joining. And also, we know that if a person come to those classes, then most likely they are committed to being a member. Amen. And so we thank the Lord for that. But before we get started in that, I want you to be first of all, Christian House of Prayer, I want y'all to be thankful and grateful every time we bring in new members. And I'm going to show you why in just a moment. Because this is a supernatural thing when a person decides to make a church their church family. I want you to turn with me to 2 Thessalonians, and we're going to go as expeditiously as we can. 1 Thessalonians chapter 2 and verse 3. And I want to read from out of the King James Version and then also out of the NIV. The King James Version and then out of the NIV. And I want to say to some of you, you know, I know that some of us are young at heart, like me. And I want you to know that if you want to use your, you know, your iPad or whatever to at church, I want you to know that does not bother me. That doesn't bother me. As long as it's not a distraction. If it's distraction, then we got people up in the ceiling and they looking. You can't see them, but they up there looking down. And if they see you trying to buy some clothes or trying to order something, we're going to know, amen? It's hard sometimes to change. But you know, if you really love God, you know that methods change, but the message will never change, amen? I prefer to have this in my hand because this is holy. Amen. My phone, I do a whole lot of stuff on that phone. But this is holy. But if you do want to use it, I don't have no problem with it. Amen. 2 Thessalonians chapter 2 and 3 in the King James Version, it says, "Let no man deceive you by any means, for that day shall not come except there come a falling away first, and that man of sin be revealed, the son of perdition." And then in the NIV, it reads like this. "Don't let anyone deceive you in any way, for that day will not come until the rebellion accusers, until the rebellion occurs and the man of lawlessness is revealed, the man doomed to destruction." Say, "The man doomed to destruction." Now, there's some key words in King James Version. It says the falling away. And then in the NIV, it says rebellion and lawlessness. Now, rebellion, this word rebellion and lawlessness, the word for that is apostasy. Say apostasy. And apostasy, when it applies to us as Christians, in Christianity, apostasy is reviewed with serious concerns because it represents a rejection of the truth, a rejection of our faith, a rejection of the teaching of Jesus Christ. Often it happens when a person did receive at one time. That's how it becomes apostasy, because at one time they received the teachings of Jesus. They received the word of God as being the truth. But something turned them around. And we know who that something, that someone is the enemy, to make them reject the true living word of God. It's an act of abandoning or renouncing one's faith and loyalty. It signifies a deliberate defection or falling away from the faith that they once professed. And there's a worldwide, I don't know if you all realize it or not, I know many of you that frequent social media, this is one of the channels that the devil is using, and we're not going to give up social media because there are some good things, not just bad things, but it's a worldwide rejection of the truth and moral principles that we believe and practice as Christians. And so 2 Thessalonians chapter 2 and 3 is a prophecy. It's not just a scripture, it's a prophecy of scripture. And it's a prophecy telling us that before Jesus returns, there will be a noticeable decline in truth, in believing, in faith. Man's lawlessness is open. It's not in the closet. It's not in the closet no more. I'm coming out of the closet, and I'm going to do what I want to do, and you like it or lump it. This is what I'm going to do. It's in opposition to God's ways and his way of doing things. It's a spirit that takes us away from the truth. It's a spirit of deception and immoral and moral decay. In other words, I can get a divorce Monday and marry somebody else on Friday. I can stand in the pulpit and I can talk about the things of the Lord and then go home and do the total opposite and have no feelings about it. Because the feelings are seared with a hot iron. That's the reason, that's how a person can move into hypocrisy, because they don't have no more feelings. Their feelings has been seared from the truth. Amen. And in this season, it has started off. This pandemic has started off with, I don't need church no more. I don't need to go to church no more. I don't need to gather. I don't need to assemble anymore. That's not the way that God is doing it anymore. That's not the way church is run anymore. That's hypocrisy. Because the word of God is the same yesterday, today, and forever. Methods might change. The way you do church might change, but the message will never change. He will not change his ways. He will not change the way he does things because it's not popular for us. He is the same yesterday, today, and forever. Bishop preached, as Sister Lena said, he preached on Wednesday, and he talked about supernatural faith and superstitious faith. Supernatural faith is trusting in God. Suspicious faith is trying God. See, we're not trying to do something. We're trusting in him to do it the way he wanted it to be done. Can I get an amen? Amen. So when we bring in these new members today, we have pushed back the power of darkness from their minds by our praise. By us believing God can do what he said he can do, he's been able to reach their hearts and their spirits. Because no matter what message we preach, no matter how good we think it is, we can jump around, do cartwheels, hang out from the chandelier and everything else. But it's the Holy Spirit. Only the Holy Spirit can convict the person that they need Jesus. Only the Holy Spirit can convict a person to say, this is my church family. This is where I'm supposed to be. So this is a supernatural thing today, people of God. And whenever we make the announcement that we're having the right hand of fellowship, you need to press your way out, because you will see before your eyes a miracle that has taken place in the lives of the people that have done that. When somebody gets saved, it can't just be business as usual. It can't be, somebody got saved. No, a lot had to take place. He uses man, he uses us to be the mouthpiece, to be to whatever we did, sang or gave a testimony or preached a word or something that had touched their heart. But the Holy Spirit had to take that through our frailties. You know, sometimes I go home and I listen to the message that I've ministered and I go, oh, I shouldn't have said that. Oh, what I said like that for. But I've learned that through even our frailties, through our wanting to be right and to have it all right and to say it all right and to be able to say it in the right spirit, we are human and we're in this flesh. We're in this flesh. And ain't no good thing in this flesh now. You know, ain't no good thing in this flesh. We got to totally rely and depend upon the Holy Spirit to do what he does. But through it all, he's able to get the job done. He's able to get the job done. And so when we usher these people in today, they're not just some people that's passing by. These are people that have said that the Lord has told me to yoke myself up with you. And who you worship, we worship. We worship Jesus in spirit and the truth. We're going to speak the same thing. We're going to walk in the same steps. We're going to have the same judgment. We're going to have the same care one for another. This is like a marriage ceremony. It's a covenant. It's a covenant. And that's the reason why people shouldn't rush into it, because it's a covenant. And the covenant means that if I offend you with my words or deed, that you won't go and leave the family because you were offended or because you didn't believe it that way. If I've done it, you come to me. If somebody else has done it, you go to them, because we're a family. Amen. And we're thankful to the Lord for bringing you our way. Amen. Okay, well, we're going to, these are the ones that have completed the class. And then next month, we'll get the rest of them, and we'll keep getting them all as we add on to this number. Amen. Come on up. I want the family of God to just take the first row. Yeah, that's good. Well, I guess they can all come at the same time. Amen. Praise the Lord. Yeah, we have a mic, and you keep my mic, and I'm gonna get y'all. Y'all gonna have a mic. Look at the Lord. Look at the Lord. Amen. And so this is a portion of the 50, and the other ones will be coming. Amen. If you're together, let me know. This is your husband, wife. All right. Well, I'm gonna let your husband introduce you two, and then I'm gonna let you speak too. So, what is your name, sir?
Jamal Cabral.
Jamal.
Jamal.
Jamal. What's your last name?
Cabral.
Cabroth.
Cabral.
Cabral.
Yes.
God bless. Brother Cabral. Amen. And this is your lovely wife?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Shari Cabral.
All right. God bless you, Shari. Where are y'all from?
I'm from the Caribbean. I was born and raised in the Caribbean.
You're from the Caribbean? Okay. What part?
Antigua and Barbuda.
Amen. Antigua and Barbuda.
Antigua and Barbuda.
Okay. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Well, we welcome you from the motherland. And thank you. Thank you for coming this way. And amen. So let me let your wife say something, then I'm going to let you say something. So has the Lord spoken to you about, where are you from?
I was born in New York, but I was raised in Antigua.
You was born in the same island?
Well, I was raised there, but I was born in New York.
You was born in New York, but you were birthed.
I was birthed in New York.
In New York.
But I was raised in Antigua.
Okay, and this is how you met him?
Yes.
Okay, I got it. Amen. Well, I'll tell you, I have never been to that island. I have been to a lot of the islands.
You should.
But I'm going to go to that island. Oh. I'm going to first have to learn how to pronounce it. And then, who knows? Who knows? Y'all might be able to take me and show me around.
Oh, yes, definitely.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Well, have you all decided what you're going to do in the ministry? Thus far?
Yet.
Not yet?
No.
Well, I'm a truck driver, so.
You're a truck driver, so yeah, you'll so be in and out?
Yeah.
Amen. Yes. Praise the Lord. Well, let me ask you this. What made you, was it the first time you came, or was you came a couple times and then you became a member?
Yes, so I came a few times. I started in November last year.
Okay.
And then, like, a month ago, I decided that I wanted to become a member.
Oh, well, you have any children?
Yes, I have three kids.
Three children, okay. Yes. Well, praise, well, we are so honored because, like I said, that's a supernatural thing. Mm-hmm. And we're so honored that the Lord showed you who your family is. Thank Amen. You. And we are your family.
Thank you.
Amen. And so you said you're a truck driver.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so I'm going to give you an assignment. Okay, so can you be one of my personal intercessors? Praying for me.
No problem.
No problem?
Yes, ma'am.
All right.
Yes, ma'am.
All right, I'm going to depend upon you. I'm going to depend upon that. Amen. And and so you all joined on the same day. And everything, and your children are there in the children's church. Are there?
Well, my oldest son is here, and the two youngest, they're back home in Antigua with my mom.
And what's this son's name?
His name is Taj.
Hey, Taj, how you doing? Give me a handshake. Can I have a handshake? Oh, I'm thinking it's him. God bless you, Taj. Have you joined as well? Are you joining as well?
He's going to school.
Austin.
Oh, you go to school in Austin. Okay. Well, praise the Lord. We'll be praying. What school? Okay. Well, God bless you, sir. Let your fly your wings, sir, and enjoy your young life. Praise the Lord. Well, we're honored to have you here, and they're going to take a picture. I'd like to take a picture with me and the new members. Go step over this a little bit, away from everybody else, and just turn around there, and they're going to take your picture. And we thank you so very much for being a part of the Christian House of Prayer.
Thank
we
you.
Pray you'll never regret the day that you've decided to come this way.
Thank
God bless you.
You.
All right. All right. You can have a seat. We're going to call you back up. Amen. Come on, move down a little bit. Move down a little bit. You by yourself?
Yes, ma'am.
Amen. So what is your name, beautiful?
It's Adrianic.
Adrianic?
Yes, ma'am.
And what's your last name?
Reg.
Reg?
Reg.
God bless.
Asia.
God bless. Sister Asia?
Yes.
Reg. Amen. Welcome.
Thank you.
Amen. And where are you from?
I'm from Atlanta, Georgia.
Put your mic up to front.
Atlanta, Georgia.
Okay. How many of you from Atlanta? Praise the Lord. Well, praise God. Y'all make sure you get her phone number and make her feel welcome. Amen. So how did you come to the ministry?
The military.
The military.
And I just retired, so. And I've been coming here about a month now.
Okay.
And I said, need a church home.
Oh, so you want to retire and stay in this area?
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, God, listen, look at God. Amen. Praise the Lord. Do you know what you're going to do in the ministry?
Yes, I'm thinking about the welcome committee.
Oh, okay. The welcome center?
Welcome center.
Oh, praise
and
God.
And hospitality.
And hospitality.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Amen. Faith, God, get her number. Well, we certainly... we're going to have a lot of hospitalities going on, things going on this year. And yes, the Welcome Center, I can see that you have a beautiful smile.
Yes,
and
ma'am.
I can see that, yeah, you do, you do. God has gifted you with that. And so
yes,
we know that when people come in, they'll be welcome.
Yes, ma'am.
Welcome to the Christian House
Thank
of
you.
Prayer.
Thank
and
you.
We are so honored to have you.
I'm happy to be here.
God bless you,
Thank
woman
you.
Of God.
Yes,
get
ma'am.
A picture.
Okay. Oh,
Amen. God bless you. We're going to call you back up in just a few minutes. Come on down. Come on, y'all. Move all the way down. Actually, I kind of like it better when it's not so many at one time, because that way we can really be able to really see you and recognize you and put your face in our mind and pray for you. Amen. How you doing?
I'm doing good.
And what is your name, sir?
Kenneth Graves.
Kenneth Graves?
Graves.
Graves.
Yes, ma'am.
God bless.
God bless.
Brother Kenneth Graves.
Brother Kenneth Graves.
God bless you, sir. Where are you from?
I'm from Dallas, and this is my wife. Right
okay,
here.
And what is your wife's name? Come on, wife, get closer. Okay?
Her name's Nina Graves.
Nina Graves.
Yes.
And both of you are from Dallas?
I'm from Dallas. She's from Los Angeles.
From Los Angeles. Okay. You from the islands, too? I know, but you look like an islander. You look like an islander.
No, he tells me don't tell people I'm from California.
Why
Texas
not?
Texas don't want to know that.
Oh, we love Californians. I got saved in California.
Okay.
Yeah, I got saved in California.
Yes.
We like California. Praise the Lord. Well, how did you come here? How did you come to the ministry?
Well, my wife actually found the church when she was going to get her hair done down the road. Mm-hmm. And then we just came and visited one time, and then we just kept coming periodically, checking out other churches, but we came back here.
Oh, well, we're so honored. You don't know what this does for us. Let your wife say something. And how did you? So you were the instrument that God used to.
Yeah. I saw the sign.
You saw the signs. The big sign out mm-hmm. there. Well, you know that sign out there. It's all about Him. That was designed by my daughter, our daughter Nicole, that's passed away back in 2009. And she designed that sign. And several times I've tried to take it down and put something else up there, but I couldn't do it. Yeah. I mean, I tell them, no, put it back up. Man. I just put up that sign that you want. Yep, take it down and put that back up. So thank you for sharing that yes. because that's why it's up there.
Yes.
It's up there so that it can draw people into yes. the light. Amen.
Yes.
Praise the Lord. So do you all know what you're going to do in the ministry yet?
I do want to get involved so bad.
You want to get involved so bad?
I'm thinking refuge.
Okay.
Food pantry.
All of that go together.
Okay.
It's Elder Solomon. Got to get her name and all of that. Don't wait for them to fill out no application. Get with them after service. And what do you want to do, sir?
Prison ministry.
Okay. Well, I can tell by what you both picked that you have a love for people. And so both of those things that you picked is an outreach where you can reach people. And that's so good. That's so wonderful. And we thank God for your heart and for you being a part. Amen. God bless you all. You can have your seat. We're going to bring you back up. I think I'm going to have y'all go in the hallway today. Oh, you hold this. Picture. See how they bully me around all the time?
Make sure you pull up to him so you can hear me. Thank you.
Mic down.
Oh. The whole church bullying me. Bishop used to always say, y'all can have your seat. Bishop used to always take the picture and say, I'll see you tonight. And my grandkids would say, tell him what you mean by that. He would wait a long time, especially when he took the pictures of the women. Take the pictures, I'll see you tonight. And then he'll wait a long, long time, then he'll say, on the picture. My grandkids would say, will you hurry up and say that? They don't know what you're talking about. You're going to see him, then see you tonight. Praise the Lord. Today would have been my mother's birthday. My sister and I, we miss Joni so much. They used to say, don't you mess with Shoni's kids, because my Joni, she'll get you if you mess with her kids. But she's on my heart today. And so after service, my sister and I is going to go and celebrate her life, her love, and her legacy. Amen. Praise God. Come on, move down a little bit. All right, so what is your name, beautiful?
Stefania Sineas.
Uh-oh. Stefania?
Yes.
Cephalion.
Stefania. Yes.
Okay, say it again.
Stefania.
God bless. Sister Stefania. Is that close?
Yes.
Praise the Lord. Amen. Where are you from?
I'm from Haiti.
You're from Haiti?
Yes.
Hallelujah. Well, we're getting a lot of the motherland. And that's a blessing, because we've been praying that God would bring them from all nations. Amen. And so we can reach out to nations, other nations. How long have you been in the United States?
14 years.
14 years. Yes. That's not a real, real long time. Mm-hmm. Amen. Well, how did you come to hear about the Christian House of Prayer?
Well, as I was sleeping, I had a dream that recently moved to Texas, and I was looking for a church. I was on the street, like, looking in my dream for a church to go, and then when I pass by, I see the sign, and then I come.
Praise God. Praise the Lord. Well, that sign working. Well, praise the Lord. Well, praise God. Well, we're so glad you had a dream, and you dreamt about that.
Yes.
And now you're in the house. You're here.
Yeah, I was looking on the street like that, walking, looking for a place
looking
to
for
go.
The place
yeah,
to go.
Looking for a church.
And God sent you to the Christian House of Prayer. Hallelujah. That's a supernatural thing. That's a supernatural thing. And we are thankful that we're not left in this world alone, but we have the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
And the Holy Ghost will lead us and guide us and direct us into all truth. So we're thankful that you've come here, and we pray that you will never regret it. You'll never regret that day. Man, do you know what you're going to do in the ministry yet?
I just want to go out and tell people how great Jesus is. That I have the urge to do that. Even though I'm a little bit shy, but in my heart I feel like I can make flyers and then tell them, even if I don't open my mouth, but the flyers will tell them how great Jesus is.
All right, well look, the SWAT team, Soul Winning Action Team. It's called Soul Winning Action Team. And they go out from door to door, knock on the door, and invite Jesus to come into their lives. And if you want to start off doing you pass out the flyer first, you can do that. We have Elder Dolly Roundtree, stand up. See her right here? Stand up. You can see her after service. Okay. She'll get your name. We'll get you some training. And then we'll take you out into the fields, to the byways and highways, and to compel people not to. When we go, we want them to be a part of the Christian House of Prayer, but that's not the reason why we go. We go so they will know Jesus. And whether they in this church or somebody else's church, as long as they know Jesus, because we all in the same universal church. Amen?
Yeah,
and so that's wonderful. That's wonderful. That's wonderful. Well, you've already told me where you're from. You already told us your name. And you already told me what you're going to do. So now we're going to have to take a picture. We're going to put our mics like this. And I want to commend, you can have a seat, we're going to bring you back up. I'm going to have you all to go in the hallway today and let the whole congregation be able to give you the right hand of fellowship. I want to pause just a minute. Come on down a little bit. I want to thank the Lord for these young people that have, that's doing the photography. I think they have 18. I think 18 of them is doing it. And they've been taking different kinds of pictures of me and changing it up and all kinds of stuff. And so, but I want the people that are not, when I say young, I'm talking about from the cradle to 35, but all of us that are above that, I want you to know that that's not, when I say young people, I don't want you to feel like I'm excluding you, because we are part of the body of Christ, and we will always be a part of the body of Christ. And the Lord need us all. They're growing. They don't have nothing. They don't have no wisdom yet. They ain't got no money. They don't have, in the natural, you know, it's like, but we need them, because we have to be able to know that when all we can do is sit there and we ain't jumping around and doing cartwheels, that the ministry is going to continue to last. The ministry is going to continue to last. Amen. So we need every age, every age. When I say young people, don't think that's a hobby horse. It's not. It's not a hobby horse, because I say that because I want them to get involved. I want them to be involved. I want them to be encouraged that we need what they got. Do we need what they got?
Yeah.
What they have, we need what they have. Come on, move down a little bit. Praise the Lord. How you doing, sir?
I'm fine. How are you?
Good. And what is your name?
Gregory Grimes.
Gregory Grimes?
Yes.
God bless.
God bless.
Brother Gregory Grimes.
Brother Gregory Grimes.
God bless you, Brother Gregory. How did you come? Where are you from, first of all?
Los Angeles, California.
Los Angeles, California. Here comes somebody else from Los Angeles. Praise the Lord. Amen. And how did you come to the ministry?
I have a friend that's here right now. She invited me. And
okay, who's your friend?
Candace?
God bless you, Candace. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Well, I'm so glad that she came. And so when you came, was it the first time you came, or did you come because Candace made you come?
It was the second time I decided.
Second time. All right. Well, we are honored. We truly are. And we don't take it for granted. We truly don't take it for granted. We are honored that you're here. Amen. And so do you know what you're going to do yet?
Ushering.
Usher, amen. I can see that. I can see you ushering. Got a beautiful smile. And ushers about, I think they're like, how many strong, y'all? How many is it of you all? 150? 150 ushers. Praise the Lord. And so they rotate because I don't want anybody just working all the time and not being able to sit down and be able to just sit and hear, just bask in God's presence, hear the word of God, and don't just work and work and work. And before we work, we got to worship. And in between that work, we got to sit down and worship some more. Amen? Amen. So thank you. Thank you for knowing what you're going to do, because many times if you don't do your part, you don't feel a part. And so you're going to feel a part because you got 150 ushers. They all men. And we got greeters that's women. So 150 ushers and greeters? Okay, ushers and greeters. But the bulk of them are men. Amen. I love the men. To the men. I need the men. Men, stand up, men. Stand up. Woo, woo. Amen. Praise the Lord. You know, Christian House of Prayer, I have a lot of the men, the ushers and the different ones, they send me pictures on Sunday afternoon saying, we got your back. I love the men. Praise the Lord. And so thank you for being a part. Thank you for deciding to do something in the house of the Lord. And I pray you'll never regret the day that you decide. And they want to take a picture with us. And we're going to put our mic like this. God bless you. Bishops used to say, okay, you can go hug her, but don't hug her too hard. You know, I said the other day, I said, you know what? I said, if God was to bring me a husband, y'all ain't gonna receive him. Y'all wouldn't receive him either. That fella would have a hard way to go. How you doing?
Good.
And what is your name, young man?
Antonio Taylor Jr. Antonio Taylor Jr.
Antonio Taylor
Jr. Antonio Taylor Jr. God bless. Antonio Taylor Jr. Amen. And so you're coming from the children's church. Now you're in the big people's church. How long you been coming over here?
I don't know.
You don't know? About a month? Do you like being over here or you want to go back over there?
Both.
Both. I understand. Well, I'm so glad that you have reached that age of accountability, I know you probably already at a younger age, you probably was at the age of accountability, but we're so honored to have you in the big house, in the big people's church. And we pray that you'll feel that we love you, we appreciate you, we honor you, and we respect you. Amen?
Yes, ma'am.
Amen. And so do you know what you're going to do in the ministry?
Sound ministry.
Sound ministry. Hallelujah. Now, That's answer to my prayer double time, because I've been praying for the sound and some things that I want to do. I want to do a talk show, and I have the tape, I have the desk for it and everything, and I haven't been able to do it because we need more sound. We need more sound people. So this is a blessing. You're coming in and you're gonna learn that sound, and if you want to go to school for sound, let me know, because I'm going to pay for it. Okay? All right. Praise the Lord. Because I believe in you. I believe in you. And so if you're getting that sound and you really feel like this is something that you can use, not only here in the Christian House of Prayer, but wherever out there, then you come see me. Okay? All right. Is this your dad? Praise the Lord. Amen. He let you stand alone today. He let you stand up like a man. Praise the Lord. We're going to take a picture. So precious. God bless you, sir. God bless you. Amen. Amen. God bless you. And who do I have here with me?
Barbara Howard.
Barbara Howard?
Yes.
Amen. God bless.
God bless.
Sister Barbara Howard.
Sister Barbara Howard.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Where are you from, Sister Barbara?
Bryan, Texas. Then I moved to Temple. And then, 3 weeks, I moved here and to Killeen.
Okay. But it's still Texas.
Yes, it's still Texas.
Well, we welcome you.
Thank you.
We welcome you, woman of God.
Thank you.
And so you came, how many times have you been coming here? A long time? Or?
Well, this would be my seventh.
Your seventh time?
I have friends that became family, and then I have coworkers here, so I saw them all, and
everybody that's connected to her, come on, let's stand. Let me see who you are. Come on. Oh, look at the Lord. Look, over here, over here. Over here, over here, over here. Well, praise the Lord. You're jolly. You have a beautiful personality.
Thank you.
And just jolly. You're the life of the party, aren't you?
Sometimes.
I could tell. Well, do you know what you're going to do in the ministry?
Greeting usher.
Greeting and usher. Praise the Lord. I can see that too. You like to tell jokes? Sometimes. Okay, I'm not going to put you on the spot. I was going to tell you to tell us. She said, thank you. I was going to tell you to tell us a joke. But
ooh.
Amen.
Oh, okay.
But we are so honored.
I can tell you one.
Okay, tell me one.
Put
the mic up to you.
Okay, there were three frogs sitting on a log. One took a notion to jump. How many was left? No one jumped. They just took the notion. You're right.
Well, you know what? Y'all rescued me because I don't get jokes. I would never have gotten it. I would never have gotten it. Bishop used to say, Val, I believe you're a genius. He said, because you understand complicated stuff, but simple stuff, you can't get it. And I don't. I'd be like, huh? What? He used to say, be who you is, because if you ain't who you is, I said, oh, I can't get that. I had to write it down and read it off the paper because I couldn't get it. But that's beautiful. Keep that sense of humor. Keep that sense of humor.
Thank you.
Praise the Lord. Well, look, what I'm going to do today, I'm going to have all of them to come back up, and we're going to make a confession of faith one to another. We're going to make a confession towards you all, and you're going to make a confession to us. And then afterwards, I'm going to have you to go out in the hallway and line up, and as the people leave out, they're going to give you the right hand of fellowship. But I want you all to come on back up now.
I didn't get a picture.
And you know she's not going to let us get away without having that picture. Can you move over just a little bit? Yeah. Okay. All right.
Thank you.
Okay. All right, I need y'all to line up. It don't matter, whichever way, however you want to go. And that's good. Okay, I'm going to welcome to the Christian House of Prayer. God bless you. Welcome to the Christian House of Prayer. Welcome to the Christian House of Prayer. Welcome, welcome, welcome to the Christian House of Prayer. Welcome, we welcome you. Now we're going to put on the Jumbotron. And there's a Jumbotron up there. I guess they can't find it. I know it if they don't have it up there. All right. Christian House of Prayer, we the members of the body of Christ,
of the family of God,
give unto you
the right hand of fellowship,
to help amongst the gospel of Jesus Christ, and it's all about Him. Now, new members, this is what I want you to repeat. New members, y'all ready? I am a member. No, No, I'll say it and then you follow me. I am a member of the body of Christ, of the family of God, now a member of the Christian House of Prayer. I receive the right hand of fellowship to help promote the gospel of Jesus Christ, and it's all about Him. Now, Father, I thank you for these members. I thank you, Father, for leading them this way. And I pray, Father, that as they remain in the courts of this ministry, that they will not wander off into another field. We agree with them today in the covenant that we have made one with another, that they will grow, they will prosper, and they will do better in this ministry. And that, Father, that they will take the word from out of these doors into their own homes, and it will make a difference. So today, as they all receive the right hand of fellowship, as they have received it from me, and now as they receive it from the congregation, I'm asking, Lord Father, to help us to be knitted together in spirit and in truth, and to lift up your Son Jesus, that men will see our light and they will glorify you, Father, which is in heaven. So, Father, do it again. Give them staying power. Give them the anointing to grow. Give them a love for this ministry and for one another. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. I want you to be led out, one of the ushers. I want you to lead them out in the hallway, and they'll go right over there where the desk is. So as everybody's going out, they will be able to give them the right hand of fellowship. You all can follow this usher right here with the green tie. They got his green tie on because he's celebrating my mother's birthday today on St. Patrick's Day. Go ahead. Come on, y'all. Hold it up with the music, because I'm going to go ahead. As they go, if there's someone here this morning and you don't know Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior, then this is the day that the Lord has made for you. Because no matter how good your life is, it can be better with Jesus. And so if you don't know Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior, and you would like to know how you can do that, as I dismiss the congregation, I want you to come up to the front, and we're going to minister to you concerning salvation, the plan of salvation. If you're a backslider and you have once knew the Lord, but seemed like something has separated you between you and your God, and you want prayer, this is one house, and we are united together in spirit and in truth. You don't have to confess your sin to us, but we will pray for you that you would regain that fellowship back that you once had. If you're someone that's here this morning and you don't have a church home and you're seeking for a church home, I offer you to come to be a member of this ministry. We're not perfect, but we serve a perfect God. And I guarantee you, your life will be better as a result of you doing that. Christian House of Prayer, let's give God praise. Give God praise. Those of you that want to be born again, those of you that want someone to pray with you concerning you're in a backslidden state, or if you want to be a member of the Christian House of Prayer, after everybody go, don't you leave out in the hallway. I need you to come to the front. We want to meet you up here at the front, and we don't want you to leave out without your need being met. Amen. Well, ain't God good? Won't He do it? Won't He do what He said He would do? He has added to this church severally as He has desired to. Let's lift up our hands to the Lord in our benediction. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make His face shine upon you and be gracious to you. May the Lord lift up His countenance upon you and give you His peace. As you leave out this morning, and you shake these new members' hand. Let them know that they have made the right decision. And before the night is over, tell somebody that Jesus Christ is Lord. You are dismissed. God bless you. God bless you. You're my brother, you're my sister.